and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. And while you're praying, and while you're in the Spirit, and while you're prayerfully watching, while you're persevering for all the saints, 19, pray for me, that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in arms, but therein I gotta speak boldly. Just say this with the minister, praying time.
Praying time.
I tell you, in the matter of the classical professional preachers, which I don't claim to be, but I admire those who are, I say, when you are learning to preach, just follow these basics. Tell them what you're going to tell them.
Yes.
Then tell them. Mm-hmm. Then tell them what you told them.
Amen.
Be anointed and you're through. That might help a whole lot of us.
My God.
Tell them what you're going to tell them, then tell them, and then tell them what you told them. Be anointed. That's what my father said. Add that. Be anointed.
Amen.
And be through.
Yes, sir.
I want to tell you something about prayer, because talked the last 2 weeks about the formulas. There are formulas that have been left for us that we might survive fires and floods and waters and struggles. People don't just get through that coincidentally.
Amen.
They're not just some lucky ones who happen to land on their feet and others go under. There are divine, God-given formulas. And formulas work for anybody, anytime, anywhere.
Yes.
Formula is universal.
Yes.
So it doesn't have friends and enemies.
Yes.
The formula for water has never changed since God created water.
Yes.
There are two molecules of hydrogen,
yes,
and one molecule of oxygen. And that's the formula, H2O. That never changes. If it changes, it's not water. Now the form can change, it can be solid. And that's called ice. It can become a gas, and it's called steam. Or it can be liquid, but the formula never changes. And so the reason that persons are making it, Sister Vienna, and others aren't, it all hinges on how well they follow the formula. And anybody can follow the formula for a fully favored life. And that includes prayer.
Right.
I'm with James, Bishop James, on 90% of what I've heard him saying right. But the one thing where I'll have to correct him when I get my next chance, we've talked before. And that is when he says favor ain't fair. That's the only thing that I would find worth objecting to, because really, favor is fair.
Yes, sir.
It may look like it's not fair, but anybody who follows the formula for favor will be favored. The only ones who are not favored are those that don't follow the formula. Is that you, Sister Rosie? Yeah, she's alive today because of the formula. They've written her off about as many times as they did her late 85-year-old mother. She's beaten the odds almost every month for the last 4 years, because no matter what they tell her, she's the to make it to worship. She gets out of the hospital on her way to church. Keeps up off her sick foot. Her eyes not working. Her kidneys not working. Her legs not working. Her heart not working. Her guts not working. Tumors and attacks and scars and disease. But I was glad when they said unto me, if I can just make it to the house of the Lord, your being here will help you get more faith. And that's why I kind of coach you along. I kind of coach you along, Sister Janet, because some people come to church, but then they abandon the formula. You don't want to just be a spectator. It's all right to sleep, but don't sleep the whole service. You don't want to come just to put on your glad rags. You don't want to just come to enjoy the entertainment. You want to come to be a part of the worship. Magnifying the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name. That's the formula. You get something when you come to join in a sanctified worship that is better than you can.